Let us now study the torque due to magnetic forces on a current carrying loop in magnetic field. Here you can see this is a uniform magnetic field in which a rectangular coil ABCD is placed, which is carrying a current I in clockwise manner. The dimensions of the loop are given as L and B. In this situation, if we just analyze the forces acting on different wire segments of this loop, here we can see that force on wire sections, if we talk about sections AB and the section CD, is zero. Directly we can write, because here the direction of current or the length is along magnetic induction, and we already discussed that those sections of wire which are parallel to magnetic field does not experience any magnetic force. Now, in this situation, we calculate the magnitude of force on the wire sections BC and DA. This can be given as F is equals to BIL, because magnetic induction and the length of wire are perpendicular to each other. And by using right hand palm rule, we can see on the section DA, magnetic force will experience the by it an inward direction, and on this section BC it will experience an upward direction, outward direction. Here we can see again, as the forces are opposite, net force on the loop will be zero, which we already discussed in previous sections. But here the line of action of these forces are not same. So these two forces, equal and opposite acting on the loop, will create a couple. So here we can calculate the torque of couple forces on loop is, this torque we can write as force magnitude multiplied by the separation between the two forces, that is B, which is the breadth of the loop. So this can be written here as BILB, which can be written as BIA, where the product of L and B is the area enclosed by the loop. Here we can also write, if there are n turns in loop, total torque, more precisely we should write magnetic torque on loop, is, this can be written as tau is equal, so we just multiplied by n, this will be BIA multiplied by n, which can be written as BINA, that is a total torque acting on the current carrying coil which is placed in the magnetic field. And this can be further modified, if the coil rotates by some angle, the magnitude of torque will change. Like here, if we tilt this coil by an angle theta in this manner, the separation between the two forces will decrease. Let's continue on the next sheet for the same. Here in continuation, you can see, if the coil is rotated by an angle such that its area vector, which is normal to the direction of this coil, makes an angle theta with the direction of magnetic induction, then in this situation also you can see the force on wire AD will be in inward direction and force on wire BC is in outward direction. The magnitude of force is same as BIL, because both of these wires are of length L. But you can see the separation between the two wires, or separation between the two line of action of these forces, is reduced to B sin theta, because when the coil was in the plane of this magnetic field, the separation was B, and when it is tilted in a way that it's normal to surface makes an angle theta with B vector, this line of action is reduced to B sin theta. So we can write, when area vector of this current carrying coil or loop makes an angle theta to direction of magnetic induction, then torque of couple of these two forces on loop is given as this can be directly calculated as torque here is BIL is the force multiplied by the separation, which is B sin theta. We also multiplied with the number of turns in the coil, how many times the wires are circulating. So here the torque can be written as here L multiplied by B can be written as area of this coil. So it will be BINA sin theta, that is the torque acting on it. Now in this situation, this constant term INA, we can replace it by a single constant M. So it can be written as MB sin theta, where M is written as the product of current number of turns and area, and this M is also a vector quantity which exists along the direction of area vector only, and its actual direction is given by right hand thumb rule. As current is circulating clockwise, M vector will exist in the direction of your thumb. I'll also write it later, but here let's just keep in mind that M, which is the product of current number of turns and area, is called magnetic dipole moment or magnetic moment of loop, current carrying loop. And in this situation, if M is considered as a vector vectorially, this torque can be given as M cross B. As if we just rotate our right hand from M to B, you can see a clockwise torque is acting on it, and due to this couple also the torque acting on the coil is in clockwise direction. And you can also write down a note over here where you can see the direction of M vector, which is equals to INA vector, is always in the direction of A vector with the right hand thumb rule pointing thumb direction when fingers along circulation of current. That means if a current is flowing in clockwise manner, you circulate your fingers, your thumb will be pointing in inward direction. So magnetic moment will exist along area vector, which is pointing in the direction of thumb. Otherwise, if we talk only about area vector for the surface which is facing this side, area vector will be perpendicular to this on the other side also. But magnetic moment will have only one direction. So just be careful about the whole analysis here.